Hello students, again we will move to our next video, which is on unit number 1 itself, introduction of energy sources and its conversion. In this video we are going to see the things which are associated with power absorbing devices. What do you mean by power absorbing devices? It is nothing but a device which requires some amount of power which we have to give it externally. That may be with the help of any kind of prime mover, that may be with the help of electricity or generator, you can say, or it may be with the help of IC engine, that is internal combustion engine, or maybe the steam engine. These are the prime movers which are generally used for running certain kind of or such a kind of power absorbing devices. So out of that, today we are going to learn at it now the device which is nothing but the pump, centrifugal pumps. Basically we are going to learn it. What are the pumps? Pumps are nothing but the equipments or devices which are used one for transportation of liquid or maybe some kind of fluids from one location to another location. For example, it may be a water, it may be petroleum products, or it may be certain kind of slurry materials like that one. As far as first year engineering students are considered one, we will restrict ourselves to whatever the syllabus is available one. Basically, pumps are classified as positive displacement pump and rotor dynamic. Positive displacements are also having the two types, reciprocating pump and rotary pump. We will be dealing with the pump, which is a centrifugal pump, which is a rotary pump. Is this clear? Okay, so we are going to dealing with that one, that is centrifugal pump. We are going to see that in the next slide. Already I have told you about the applications, that how it can be used when in petroleum products, transfer of raw material which is in the form of a fluid, in the form of firefighting systems, in the form of pumping of the waters, as well as hydraulic control systems. We are going to use that. Now, centrifugal pump. A pump is a hydraulic machine. Here there are some simple definition is given. A pump is a hydraulic machine which converts mechanical energy into hydraulic energy or pressure energy. That is for transfer from transportation of the fluid from one location to another location. This is working on the principle of centrifugal force. In this type of pump, this liquid which is moving from one location to another location, it's subjected to whirling motion, or you can say some certain kind of rotary motion, in which rotating impeller inside which is made up of number of backward currents. When I will show you the picture, then it will be very clear to you. So that this is responsible for having certain kind of generation of pressure as well as velocity of that fluid, so that it will be discharged to the destination purpose. Okay, now centrifugal pumps are having this kind of types. We will not go into the details of that one. That is according to the number of impellers used, according to the position of the shaft of the impeller, and according to the head. Head means whatever means what is the height at which it can have the supply of lifting of that water as well as supply of it to the destination power, depending on that particular height, or you can say the whatever the depth from which it can be lifted up, it will be dependent on that one as far as head of this centrifugal pump is considered one. This is the rotor, or this is the shaft on which these impellers are mounted. This is impeller, and the first impeller, second impeller, which is the case as far as multi-stage pumps are considered one. These things are the types, as well as this one I have just added it for the information purpose. No need to remember all these things, because it is not the part of your syllabus, but still as a matter of understanding I have just added it. Now this is the figure which is giving you much more correct idea, that this is the block diagram of the centrifugal pump. This is the suction pipe. You just see suction pipe is available one, and this is the delivery pipe. here we are having this from this the central line. This is the area wherever this is nothing but the part of a centrifugal pump. Now this is the eye of the impeller. This whatever the backward curved vanes you are going to see, this is the one vane, this is the another vane, this is the another vane like this one, and this is the eye of the, this is the shaft, and here is the eye of the impeller like this one. So I think it is clear as far as this particular figure is considered. One, these things are enclosed in the casing, which is a volute casing having a diverging, having the increasing cross sectional area. You can see as far as it is attached to the delivery pipe. This is the delivery pipe actually, and this is the delivery valve. Okay. Now this is the total head. This is the total head. Already have told you, as far as depending upon the head, it can be classified as low head, medium head, and high head pumps. So it is nothing but the total head, that is the discharge head as well as the whatever the suction head. The total head is the addition of that one, that is depending upon from wherever or from which how much amount of depth it can be in lifting the water, as well as from how much amount of at what height it can just try to supply this particular water. Okay, now we will just move to our next explanation. So these are the some certain terms. Now this is the foot wall, which is, now this is the area. It may be a well, it may be any kind of storage of water from which it can be lifted. So to avoid whenever the water enters here, whenever we are going to make the centrifugal pump on this whatever the impeller, which is having the backward curve and gets rotated, and here whatever the low pressure area which is created, whatever the suction is created, not that is the high pressure area which is created, one which sucks this particular water from the storage area due to the whatever the pressure drop which is available, or you can say which is occurred there. So this foot wall is just taking care of avoiding the entry of the some dust particles, dirt particles, or maybe the sands and all that things particles, so that there should not be the choking up of this particular suction pipe. So this foot wall is non-retent type of wall, which is strainer is doing that particular function of getting all these things, whatever the sediments and all that things, as far as that filtration can be taking place. But and foot wall is a non-retent type of wall, which is just avoiding the flow of water which is inside this particular pipe to the storage, so that this particular suction pipe is always filled with water whenever it is not in working condition. For that purpose, foot valve is provided. Now, whenever the water is sucked, as far as whenever we are making this centrifugal pump on, at that time, whenever it is coming inside this casing, with the help of this backward curved vents, due to the centrifugal action, that water gets rotated. It's having its kinetic energy increased one, and it is having the high amount of velocity as well as pressure due to the centrifugal action. And due to that one, it will be moving through this volute casing to the means that high pressurized as well as high velocity water. That is, its mechanical energy will be converting into its pressure energy, and which will be supplied to the destination purpose at a high pressure as well as high velocity to the destination purpose. So in this way, as far as how that particular centrifugal pump is used, one for lifting of water from one location to the another location, this figure is indicating you the same thing here, which is nothing but the block diagram, strainer and foot wall. This is nothing but the suction head, this is nothing but the discharge head, this is a simple simple diagram, block diagram for the centrifugal pump. These are the walls. This is delivery wall, delivery pipe. Here the suction wall is also there, if at all it will be required. But generally it is not shown here actually. The foot wall is acting as actually the wall, which is a non-retent type of wall, which will not allow the water which is from this, which is available inside this pipe, to just drain out through this particular suction pipe. To avoid that one, it is used one. So in this way, this is the explanation for construction and working of this centrifugal pump. Now you might have observed in your house, in your buildings, in your various applications, we are using the centrifugal pump, which is attached with the electric motor, because electric motor is the prime mover, which is used one for that purpose. We can use the generator also, we can use IC engine also for that one, and because this is getting the external power Therefore, it is known as power absorbing device. Okay, for lifting the water from one location from the tank which is available at, in the ground to the higher top level of the building, as well as in various applications it can be used one. So in this way, this is also the same figure here. Water sump is available one which is inside the earth, and this is the overhead tank at on the building, and these are the again suction pipe. This is again the delivery pipe, delivery wall. Wow, this is a foot wall strainer. Okay, here the things are already available one. Suction tight, suction flange. Flange means what happens here? This is the centrifugal pump. So this is the pipe which is coming out from the eye of the impeller, which will be connected to suction pipe. And this is the outlet of the pump, which is connected to the delivery pipe. That is the only change. And the remaining things are similar one. What do you mean by the eye of the impeller? How the casing is there? What is the function of it? That already I have told you. So I think this is from my side as far as working of the centrifugal pump is considered one. For this one, I have just used this whatever the references which are available one there. So we will just try to stop here. In the next lecture, we are going to see about the next power absorbing device.